I love you, Miles.
Yeah, I know, Dad.
You gotta say I love you back.
Dad, are you serious?
I want to hear it.
You want to hear me say it?
I love you, Dad.
You're dropping me off out of school?
I love you, Dad.
Look at this place.
Dad, I love you.
Dad, I love you.
That's a copy.
Oh, my God. Oh, my God, no. Please, no. Hey guys, what's up? It's your girl. Can't even talk anymore. That scene with the father, I would have run back to the car and be like, I love you, Daddy. Daddy Kens, you are the... I would have run. Like, this scene has given so many cop dads some very bad ideas. But, oh my God. Okay, so, this trailer came out like 2 days ago, but I wasn't able to bring it up because I've been having Wi-Fi problems. No money, which is why I created a Ko-fi page. Yeah, I made a community post about this, but I don't want to like slam it down any more people's throats. If you want to support me, that would be so much appreciated. But yeah, for the next 12 days or so, 12-13, I might not be able to get out content. But let's get back to this because it's really awesome. Who cares about my financial instability? So Spider-Man Into the Spider-Verse, the official trailer came out, you know, the one that's gonna come out in November. Is it November? No, December, Christmas. And it came out last year, just like a teaser clip or something, and people were freaking out. So this trailer basically centers around Miles Morales and his story of being Spider-Man. So it's just a really good trailer. It's awesome. But a lot of people have a fear because it's Sony Animations, and I too have that fear. Sony Animations made The Angry Birds, the movie, I think, and well, whereas a lot of people hated it, I really enjoyed The Angry Birds. It was really funny, but just because I enjoyed it does not mean I'm not self-aware enough to know it's hot garbage. It's like terrible. But there was enjoyment to be had. They also made the Smurf movies, which I've never watched any of them. I think the first Smurf movie with I forgot his name. The guy who's gay but acts like the most straight man on earth in How I Met Your Mother. Chris Pat Harris. I know he's very popular and he has like three names. Patrick, Chris Harrison, Chris Pat Harris. There's no Chris, but there's Patrick and there's Harrison. So that's the one I watched, but I didn't really pay much attention to it. I think I watched it from beginning to end or watched it in pieces. Who cares? So Sony Animations, they have this rep for not being the good animation company, but Sony owns the rights to Spider-Man and only gave partial, at least a little part of it to Marvel. That's why we have Spider-Man Homecoming. And here's the thing with me, I had this conversation with Jay last night before I ever recorded this. I am so desensitized to Spider-Man because it's one of the most overly used, overly saturated Marvel characters in the known universe.
You have a new Spider-Man movie every 2 years or so. You have a new animated series every 6 months. Like, I really liked the Spider-Man animated. Like, there's so many spectacular, amazing. I can't even remember which one I liked, but then they stopped doing the one I liked. I think it was Spectacular or something. But then they started doing another one. I can't even remember the name, but I know it had Tigress in it and Iron Fist. They were all teenagers and like Nick Fury recruited Spider-Man, and I really, really liked that one. Well, I really liked it for Iron Fist, but I also liked the story. But then they changed that one for Web Warriors, and now they're doing another one with Dr. Octavius, I think, being a hero, and I think it also has Gwen, Gwen as Spider-Man. It's just so, it's too much Spider-Man, and I think that's the reason why I don't know as much about him, because I'm just so confused with each different iterations. Like I was telling Jay last night, one iteration he likes a girl named Gwen, another one he's in love with one named Mary Jane, and I'm like, well, which one was the one that died? And he was like, it's Mary Jane. And I'm like, okay. The last Spider-Man I gave a chance was when Andrew Garfield played Spider-Man, because he was cute, he was really cute, but I could not get past the first 30 minutes of the first movie, and I could not get past the first 20 minutes of the second movie, because I can't, I just don't know why. And I haven't watched Spider-Man Homecoming, by the way, because it was just one of those things where I was like, you know what, just no, how about a big nope? But a lot of people are telling me to give it a chance, it's accurate to the real Spider-Man, and I'm like, I don't know who the real Spider-Man is anymore. I don't know what he's supposed to be or he's supposed to represent, because I've never read a Spider-Man comic before. I'm more attached to animated series of Marvel properties. I'm going on a long mini rant here, but it gives more context. So in the Spider-Man animated series that I was watching, the one where Nick Fury recruited Spider-Man, I know the name. It has to be something Heroes, because I know they were playing Avengers, Earth's Mightiest Heroes. I really like that one too. So Spider-Man was interacting with multiple universes, and one of them had Miles Morales in them. And I was just surprised. I was like, there's a black Spider-Man? And apparently in Miles' universe, Spider-Man died because he was having a fight with the Goblin or something like that. And it really freaked Peter Parker out. And ever since then, I was kind of like intrigued by Miles' character, but never looked that much deeply into it. So when this movie was centered around it, I'm hearing words that people are hating it, that Miles is stealing Peter Parker's shine. And I'm like, you have 11 billion other Peter Parker inspired properties. Let another Spider-Man shine. Let Peter Parker rest, please. He's a very good character, but the way these corporations are trying to milk him for everything he's worth, it's not just not cool. The moment one thing doesn't work out, they immediately jump ship to another thing and don't even try for a second to improve what's already established. So,
ooh, finally, I'm done with this mini rant. Unless I remember something, I'll come back. Into the Spider-Verse, it's so cool. I loved the comic book style animation. Like, the first few seconds of the trailer, I was like, oh my god, what is this? It doesn't look like an animation I'm used to. It looks so weird. I'm boxy, bulky. But then I just saw the rest of the trailer. I liked, apparently I watched Beyond the Trailer's live reaction to this, and I think her name is Grace. She was talking about how Miles is half African American and half Latino, and I was like, how does that work? And then a part of my brain goes, well, when a mommy Latino and a daddy black person like each other very much. And I was like, I get how it works, but you don't hear that combination in comic books. It's just that in animated properties, in comic books, TV shows, I don't really get that combination of lovers. It's either one parent is African American or Latino. I don't really know of any Latino superheroes, but it's either one is different and one is white or something like that, or both are different. But to see two different types of things, I guess, it's really interesting. I really liked it. And the jokes is so Sony animations. I really like the jokes. Like I said, I like the Angry Birds movie with Miles Morales' dad being a cop saying, your dad doesn't run red lights. And I was like, cops can run red lights? That's so cool. So they're talking about how this universe mirrors, this is another universe, because you see something, cola, soda, that made me pause. And I was like, okay, is this a narration thing? Or did you see the other universe? And from what I understand, Miles Morales saw when Peter Parker died. So I don't know if this grown-up version, is it Spider-Man? Or is in his universe, Spider-Man is a washed-up character? Or if Spider-Man did die and then this was like his replacement or somebody that took up the mantle. And Miles also has like spider powers, because he was trying to convince himself that no, it was a normal spider. You see it in like the classic comic book text as he's running, that it's a normal spider, he's just having puberty and he's a normal kid. And I just it looks so good, you guys. And personal, this is just a personal thing, if I was given a radioactive spider and they were like, touch it, it's dead, and they were like, touch it and you get all the powers of a spider, I'll be like, keep your goddamn spider powers. I hate spiders. Even if I could have the ability to swing through the city, it won't really matter here because we don't really have skyscrapers or anything. But I just don't want, even the whole spidey sense thing, I'm always at home, so nothing can actually hit me without me knowing. So the powers of a spider will be useless here in Africa from you. Well, my portion of it anyway. And you can just see the spider mentor is shady as all hell. He's like, you got money on you, right? I'm not liquid. And I'm like, are you Peter Parker or are you someone else? He looks like Peter Parker, but like, again, I don't know anything about Miles Morales or this universe. I don't know the type of Spider-Man story they're trying to tell, because there's like 10 trillion of them. And Miles is like, how am I supposed to save the world? And he's like, you're only supposed to save one person. And I'm like, what? That is not something you tell a super. I'm trying to say, you're supposed to only save yourself, or you're only supposed to save the one person that's in danger? Because sometimes there are multiple people that's in danger. Or is it that you put yourself in harm's way, but at the end of the day you look after number one? And I love Miles' costume, where he's like black and red. It's really just cool. I always thought it was because he's black, but I think it's also like a way to differentiate him from the normal Spider-Man colors. Because then Spider-Gwen comes in, which also confuses me. I'm seeing a purple Spider-Man. The colors in this thing are god tier. And then Miles just disappears. And I'm like, okay, what are you those type of spiders that when you look one way, you look back and they're no longer there? Do spiders have invisibility powers? Because I will believe that if somebody told me. And with Spider-Gwen, I also got confused because she said her name was Gwen Stacy, and I was like, yes, Gwen Stacy, she's the person that Spider-Man likes. But then she looked the same age as Miles Morales, so I was like, are you a different Gwen? But then Jay explained to me that no, it's still the same Gwen that was with Spider-Man. So I'm like, okay, in this universe, did she find out that Peter Parker was Spider-Man, he died, and she became Spider-Gwen? Or she became Spider-Gwen because she just had her own beliefs? I like it. I like her costume too, how it's white. It's really clean, which doesn't make any sense with the kind of activity she plans to do. And I think this is you know, the usual coming of age superhero origin story. So this is like Miles Morales' own, and it's actually one that I don't know how he got his powers. I don't know anything about him. So I'm really, really, really looking forward to this show and what it brings and what it presents. Also, final note, I have not watched Avengers Infinity War. It isn't out here yet, and I know me putting that disclaimer will promote some asshole to tell me how it ends, but I've already been spoiled enough. So if you could please leave out any Avengers related comment, just please do so. I'm really even contemplating if it's worth it watching the movie anymore, since I know some of the stuff that's gonna happen. Salty rant over. And finally, we have the awkward scene between Miles and his dad that made literal tears nearly come out of my eyes. It was I think he's in a boarding school, because you see him with a backpack and like a trolley, so maybe that's it. So if his parents drop him off at boarding school, then he always sneaks out because they have a uniform and everything, and this is New York. But no, New York is Brooklyn isn't New York. I am confused. I just woke up. I'm sorry, I know this thing is really long, but I had just a lot of thoughts on the topic, and it's just so cool. It looks friggin' amazing. I cannot wait. 6 months left. It's like the season of trailers. And the final joke also, I didn't hear it very well, but now I hear it more clearly. It's like, Miles is like, how many Spider-Men are there? And he's like, the same at a Comic-Con convention. And I'm like, he was like, what? And I just couldn't help but laugh. It was like, I think that Spider-Man is not from this universe, because he's saying things that Miles doesn't understand. I don't know, but I'm hopeful. I look forward to it. Please tell me your thoughts in the comments below, because I've already said everything that's humanly possible for me to say, and I look forward to hearing what you have to say. But with that being said, thanks so much for clicking to watch. This is TVC, signing out.